Hi guys, this is Suresh. I thought of sharing my knowledge to everyone on MEP aspects. MEP is nothing but mechanical, electrical and plumbing. It is a big division altogether in a construction industry. So I thought of sharing the knowledge. So many of you may need of that. Okay, we'll get into the topic. Mechanical. In mechanical, there are multiple packages get involved, like HVAC, heat, ventilation and air conditioning. Fire protection system, sprinkler, water curtain, hydrant, etc. Similarly, vertical transportation, we will call as a lift, elevators, escalators, etc. Same thing in the electrical, we are having three divisions like HT, LT and ELV. HT is altogether before transformer, all the high tension lines, 11 kilowatt, kilovolt and above. LT is low tension, which is 440 volt and below. ELV, extra low voltage, generally we will use for CCTV, access control, FAPA, BMS, etc. Here you can see the fresh air and exhaust unit, which is kept at the terrace level. It is a part of HVAC system. Firefighting system is most common in all the high-risk buildings, commercial buildings and the industrial buildings. It is the authority requirement in India for all high-risk buildings, which is above 15 meter. Lifts are a part of mechanical division. Lifts generally used in all apartments, commercial buildings for the easy transportations. In electrical, high tension HT, which is inclusive of grids, RMU, metering cubicle, HT panel and transformer. Transformer is used to step down the higher voltage into lower voltage, into low tension. After we convert or we step down the higher voltage to lower voltage, that is 440 volt, that will be controlled with all the panels, which we will kept in the main LT room panel in all the commercial buildings, all residential buildings. From there, it will be divided equally and will take into individual floors for utility loads, etc. Extra low voltage will be for CCTV, access control, FAPA, BMS, etc. Generally, it will have a main control panel in BMS room or any one of the control room. From there, total everything will get controlled. The main input for this panel will always will be from the UPS package to avoid any power interruption. Public health engineering, PHE, plays a major role. Water supply system, drainage system, STP, WTP. Sewage treatment plant, water treatment plant, etc. In plumbing, for drainage and water supply, we have different types of pipes used for different purpose that we will study in detail in the upcoming videos. Sewage treatment plant will be quite commonly used in the higher occupancy building. So this is used to treat the sewage water. Once the sewage water is treated, then it will be used as a recycling water for flushing, or it can be connected to the municipality drainage water, so it will be go as a treated water outside the building. There are other packages as well, which is EPS, battery, solar system, diesel generator, HSDR, grease trap, BTU meter, etc. I'm trying to list it out all the packages so that we will not miss out in the upcoming videos. So we will elaborately see one by one in the future. In any building will be designed with international, national and local standards with a certain specification. And there are some authority approvals required for every buildings. In that architect, MEP consultant will be involved. Their scopes, there are different types of drawings available, which will be tender drawing, good for construction, shop drawing, as-built drawing, etc. Then there is a detailed checklist available for all MEP packages. Next, like similarly, we have a list of materials, what are the make list available in the market and what is their quality, what is their specification. In detail, we can get. Similarly, the quality of materials with the test certificate we can obtain from the market or from the manufacturer. Procedure of checking the material quality and work at execution. See, there will be so many works happening parallelly at a site at different time. Sometimes the workmanship matters a lot. Due to the poor workmanship, we will face a lot of quality issue. So those checking we will do by proper checking methodology. Similarly, material tracking, there are some long lead item will be there. There are some material which will not be in critical mode. So we should know which is critical, we should know which is not critical. Accordingly, we need to start tracking the material. Next, for everything, there is a testing procedure. So those things we will study in detail. Next, overall cost per square feet. in a certain building, if certain package is done, what will be the cost per square feet, that we should know. Similarly, preparation of BOQ. BOQ is bill of quantities. So what are the items coming in a building? So what is the quantity? What is the description? So we should include all the scope properly so that none of the material will be missed or none of the description will be missed. So accordingly, we need to issue the purchase order. If anything missed out in the BOQ, that will be called as a non-tender item, which will be used in the projects at the later stage. So similarly, once the work is done, then measurement verification to be done. So while doing the project, safety norms and standards to be maintained. And similarly, the safety officer will be deployed at site and you should know what is your roles and responsibility. So generally, we need to take a toolbox talk to the people or the execution team. At a regular interval, we should conduct the fire mock drill. And the safety induction has to be provided, complete in single video. So I am planning to elaborate everything in detail one by one. So maximum of MEP aspect about a complete building, I will give a complete understanding or complete download. People those who want to make use of that, please make use of this. Thank you so much.